All right, folks, welcome to Simulink for Chemies, where we go through all of the ways that Simulink can ease your process control pain. Today we're dealing with systems of higher order transfer functions, but we're also going to make first order plus dead time approximations to make the math easier. Higher order systems can be approximated with first order plus dead time functions, or FOPDTs. These can be expressed in the general form k times e to the negative theta s over tau s plus 1. Notice that it looks a lot like a regular first-order transfer function, but it has this extra exponential term added. This is the dead time. And there are several different methods you can use, such as the Taylor or the Skogestad methods, to develop these FOPDTs. Now, our goal for today is to use the Taylor and the Skogestad methods to approximate this given series of transfer functions. How do the two approximations differ from one another and from the original model? Now, Simulink is a great tool for answering graphical, qualitative questions like this one. So we're already presented with a system on the screen. It consists of a step input, three first-order transfer functions linked in series, a mux, and a scope. Placing Simulink blocks in series like this is equivalent to multiplying the blocks together. If we wanted to, we could write these three first-order transfer functions as one third-order transfer function. So we're going to develop these first-order plus dead time models, and then compare them to the system as well as to one another. And there's no magical FOPDT block that we can drag and drop in Simulink, but we can make a FOPDT by multiplying two different blocks together. First, we put down a transfer function block. Then we multiply that signal by a transport delay block, which gives us our dead time. All right, so let's hook up the step input to the transfer function and attach the transport delay to the mux. And this will enable us to compare the real transfer function to the approximation. We're also going to make a second FOPDT. So we can highlight the blocks by shift-clicking them, press Ctrl-C to copy, and then press Ctrl-V to paste. We'll need an extra port on the mux block for this new input. And then we have to connect it to the step. So let's make this top FOPDT a Taylor approximation, and the bottom one a Skogestad approximation. Let's do the Taylor one first. For a Taylor FOPDT, the gain of the process is still the gain of the FOPDT. Therefore, k equals 6. Tau, the time constant, is equal to the largest time constant in the process. So in the process, we have a time constant of 2, a 4, and a 6. So the tau for the Taylor approximation is 6. The dead time is equal to the other time constants in the denominator that aren't tau, plus any dead time that already exists in the system. So we've already used the 6 as our tau. But we still have time constants of 2 and 4, and there aren't any transport delay blocks in the original process to signify dead time, so the dead time for our Taylor FOPDT is 6. It's these two extra transfer functions here. Therefore, our Taylor approximation is 6 times e to the negative 6s over 6s plus 1. What this means for the Simulink model is that the transfer function will equal 6 divided by 6s plus 1. The e to the negative 6s term goes in the transport delay as a time lag of 6 minutes. The FOPDT using Skogestad's half rule will be a little bit different. The process gain is again the gain of the FOPDT, k equals 6. Now for a Skogestad approximation, tau equals the largest time constant plus half of the second largest time constant. So this would be 6 plus 1 half of 4, which is 2. So our tau is 8 because 6 plus 2 is 8. The dead time is equal to the other half of the second largest time constant plus all of the others. So we have the half of the 4, which is 2, plus this 2, which equals 4. So our dead time is 4. Therefore, our Skogestad approximation is 6 times e to the negative 4s over 8s plus 1. So in our transfer function block, we put in 6 over 8s plus 1. And then our transport delay is 4 minutes. We'll save our progress just in case. set our runtime to 50 minutes. Save again and press run and click on scope. So what do we see? The original third order transfer function is in yellow. You can tell this because it doesn't have any dead time. It just starts increasing at time zero. The magenta curve is from the Taylor FOPDT. It has the longest dead time. It underestimates the values for the original system until about 9 minutes in. Then it overestimates the values. The cyan line comes from the FOPDT derived by Skogstad's half rule. It tends to stay closer to the yellow line, and because they intersect twice, the Skogstad FOPDT serves as a better approximation of the original system, both at earlier and at later times. Cool. I hope you enjoyed doing some first order plus dead time approximations this afternoon. I know I did. If you want to learn more about using Simulink to solve process control problems, you can subscribe to the Lafayette CHBE YouTube channel.